Oh yeah, we're covering this one now. Let's watch the opening. Everyone knows this opening, but let's just watch it anyway. Look at him go. Look at him go. He's doing good. He's doing good for himself. Until, oh! Get out of here, Cranky, you stupid record player. Who even cares, man? Oh, but he's getting his revenge. Oh! And we're here with Donkey Kong Country for the Super Nintendo. This is one of my absolute favorite games for the Super Nintendo. It is a friggin' awesome game. It's aged fairly well. I would still debate that later in the game, maybe it gets a bit cheap, gets a bit cheap deathy. So I mean that kind of sucks, but overall it's a fun game. I highly recommend it for all two of you that haven't played it yet. We're gonna go into the banana horde and oh, it's all empty. DK sad, setting up the premise of the game. King K. Rool has stolen Donkey Kong's nanners. We gotta go collect them back by going through all the levels and beating the bosses. We're gonna grab an extra life here in the form of balloons. This game throws you right into the action. Typical Super Nintendo fashion. Fashion action. And the main mechanic of the game in order to keep yourself going is to get your other Donkey Kong buddy out of a barrel, Diddy Kong. This is the second game that he appeared in, the first being Diddy Kong Racing, developed by Rare, as this game was an original character developed by Rare, mind you. And, oh yeah, look at that. It's freaking great, man. Love this game. I really do. It doesn't waste any time with things. It doesn't... Just straightforward action and difficulty, and it's lots of fun. There are still some gripes I have with the game, looking back on it, but you know what? The gripes are still paling in comparison to just all the things that were done right. Man, were they done right. Like, they hit dead on with this game. Friggin' amazing. Looked great for the time, too. Those silicone graphics. They look great, man. Again, you know, they could probably look better nowadays, but whatever. It's whatever. You can tell what everything is. It's all good. Lots packed in this first level that teaches you a whole lot about the game. They teach you that balloons give you extra lives. They teach you that there are animal buddies you can ride on, just like in Super Mario World with Yoshi. And it teaches you that there are secret rooms that you can get little bonus things in. Shows you these, like, gold animal things you can collect that I think I mess up horribly on. But, yeah, well, there we go. Aw, poor Diddy. Like, just stomping on his hat. Good lord. Just amazing, man. Anyway, we're doing this Let's Play right now. We're doing it just for more filler. I finally have a date set. I'm uploading this on Monday. But, amazingly, I'm getting my room back hopefully by Wednesday or Thursday, which is really cool. But I'm still putting this out because it's going to take some time to, like, you know, get everything back into my room, get everything moved back in, get everything, like, cable-wise, like, all reset up. So I just recorded one more little side Let's Play that I've always wanted to do, but I never really had time for, so I was like, okay, let's record some Donkey Kong Country. It's been long enough. I've put off this entire franchise for so long, and I'm always talking about it, too, from time to time, so it was only a matter of time before I actually decided to Let's Play one of the games. And here's the first one. Probably not the one that I'm the most familiar with. Like, we're not doing a 100% run or anything here. I remember when I was really young, I actually got 100... or whatever, what's the max percentage on the second one? Is it the 102% for some reason on Donkey Kong Country 2? I think so. Or whatever. Anyway, I got the max percentage on that before. Because a friend of mine lended me, like, the Game Boy Advance version of it. So I've gotten 100% on that game before. But, man, that was years ago. And I remember nothing about the game. But at some point, I would really like to cover the entire trilogy. It's just a lot of fun. Every game, like, it's the same foundation, but they, like, change it up, like, just a little bit. It's really cool. It's, every game just feels really different in the trilogy. Probably, I would argue that Donkey Kong Country is probably one of the greatest trilogies in gaming, I would definitely go that far. Because I find that even if there are, like, other good trilogies, they usually get ruined because they'll try to, like, add the fourth one in, you know? They kind of go... They do the Star Wars thing. They pull a Star Wars and add more crappy sequels. Not crappy, but, like, you know, like mediocre, lesser sequels that take away from the iconic status of the original trilogy. But I think Donkey Kong Country holds up as a great trilogy. I wouldn't even call Donkey Kong Country Returns to be, like, additions to that series, because it's kind of more like a reboot, a soft reboot to the series. But even if you wanted to count it, they're very well received and they're a lot of fun on their own, so I would still say that they show themselves well against the original three. And another cool thing is that Metroid Prime is another game trilogy that I think fared extremely well and was probably one of the greatest of the new millennium so far. And it's developed by a team, Retro, that had ex-Rare members that also worked on Donkey Kong Country. So, I mean, like, good lord, man. Like, I think we're starting to see a pattern here. That Rare is, like, full of legendary pioneers of the industry. And they know their stuff, man. Good lord. Them crazy Brits. They know what they're doing, man. They know what they're doing with all their codes and numerating and denominating and putting googly eyes on everything. It's just amazing. Just great. I always like these cavern levels in Donkey Kong Country. These are great, man. Love it. I don't know why, because in a lot of other games, I'm never really a fan of, like, these cave levels. I always just find them kind of, like, dank and boring to look at, but I always like the caverns in Donkey Kong Country. Don't know why. I don't know, the caverns and, like, the mineshaft levels. I always like those ones. But, I don't know. There's one in the second world that I especially like the design of. It's, like, the really, like, dark, like, purple-looking place, and, like, you can get the frog in it. There's lots of, like, tires everywhere to jump on. And the shtick they're kind of going for is to teach you that, like, you're gonna have to use tires to maneuver around obstacles that you can't destroy. Really cool. The first couple worlds are great for teaching you things, because then by the third and fourth and fifth world, they throw you right into the thick of the difficulty. Good lord, man. Like, if I were to make a bar graph of the difficulty, the fluctuating difficulty of the game, oh my lord. Ridiculous. We have a water section here as well. This game's got it all, man. This is like the Swiss Army knife of platformers. Like, oh, let's just throw in a water section just cuz. You know, let's throw in minecart levels just cuz. Let's throw in a level where it's like pitch black and lights up just for a couple seconds. You know, just cuz. This is the real Just Cuz series. You know, just making some topical humor about a franchise that I think finished like 2 or 3 years ago. Anyway, whatever. I don't even know what those games are about. Let's go down here and pick up On Guard. This is one of those games where, like, me and my cousin used to play it all the time. We used to play it at my great aunt's house, God rest her soul. And this was one of the games. This, Turok, GoldenEye, and Super Mario World. These were, like, the four games. Because, believe it or not, my great aunt was actually quite the gamer. When I was younger, she really liked playing games with us and everything. She absolutely loved the Super Nintendo, and she liked the N64 even better. She was like the living proof that old people can not only get into gaming, but that the 2D to 3D transition, I guess, wasn't quite as generation-oriented as we thought. Very interesting. But anyway, yeah, so we used to play this all the time, and good lord, man, I have so many embarrassing stories. Like, just, like, dumb things we always talked about and did because we were kids playing these games. I don't know, just freaking embarrassing things. We always used to call, because we never beat the game ourselves. It was only our aunt that beat the game. But we never beat it as kids. But my cousin and I, we'd always give the animal buddies, like, their own names because we never knew that they had names. And there's no, like, the copy that my aunt had, like, there's no manual or anything for it. So, we'd always call the swordfish Sword. I don't know why, man. I guess because we didn't know how to read. So when we thought of the word sword, we just saw, like, the W and we were like, Sword. So that's what we called him. Dumb, I know, and freaking just, like, stupid. Like, shut up, Will. Dumb, embarrassing stories. I have so many embarrassing stories about, like, Super Mario World 2. Just, like, some of the dumb things. Well, I've shared a lot of them in the original Let's Play, but... Good lord. I don't even know, man. Oh, just dumb. Dumb things. I believe this is the level where I show off my first death, too. Because, these barrel sections, man. I was not seasoned at the time. Like, I didn't put any, like, practice in. I just kind of winged this entire Let's Play. But there's a secret right here, I think. Yeah. You can blow into the wall intentionally. And, you can get this bonus room. I like these bonus rooms the best because it's impossible to fail them. Just keep tapping A and you'll get every one no matter how fast they go. I like those ones because of that. There's a little trick to them. Gonna bop these few guys. Because there is a bonus. Yeah, right there in the middle one. There's quite a few bonuses in this level, so you gotta make sure you get them. There we go. Another cool little trick there. In those kind of rooms, if you can time the angle, like where you are, like, just perfectly, you'll be able to get a second shot at those three prize rooms. You can get two of the prizes. Because there's always one that's, like, dumb and doesn't matter, so I just run off the side. But yeah, if you time it right, you can get the two prizes that are actually good in those rooms. So, you know, you can have your cake and eat it. You can have your banana and peel it. You know, if we're gonna make monkey puns. There, I don't think I timed it right that time, though. I think I, like, just barely mistimed that. But oh well. Oop, there we go. Friggin' awesome, man. Of course, if you've watched the game, and again, have no idea what this game is, there are, like, letters hidden throughout the levels as well. K-O-N-G, spelling Kong. If you can collect all four letters in every level, you can get a 1-up, which is really cool. And apparently I need them because I keep dying, which is great. Because, I used to have this whole system going, like, this is part of me, like, I game almost purely on muscle memory. It's pretty bad. But I used to have very specific timings and, like, rhythms to doing these barrel sections, like, flawlessly. And because I can't perfectly remember them, I was, like, trying to recall them. So instead of actually going off of, like, my skill and reaction time, I was just trying to memorize when to press the A button. So, yeah. I think it was this time I was like, okay, like, let's just actually do it. Yeah. Nope, made the same mistake as last time. All right. That's fine, Will. It's all right, man. It's a 15-minute episode. We can spare the time. I don't even care, man. I'm just glad to be getting my room back sometime this week. I'm fine with that. I'm also finally off of my extra couple shifts a week training people, so this is the week that I can go back to my regular schedule. Everything is going back to normal this week. I'm so happy because it has been close to 3 weeks since I've had that. Not to mention, I can finally start recording some things again later this week, and I can finally get YGPT done, because I'm really excited to show that to you guys. It's, it might be a little bit controversial, and maybe some people won't agree with me, but, to have that sort of disagreement happening, that's kind of what I want to happen. Because, if people are disagreeing with the points I make, that means that they're still, you know, digesting my thoughts. So, it'll be nice to at least generate some multiple viewpoints, I think. Or to get people at least thinking about both sides of the coin. I think it's gonna be really interesting. It's about a very successful game. And I kinda take an opposite approach with it. So, I'm hoping if I can get the things recorded and everything, it should be done for, like, next Tuesday. Definitely. And then we'll be back onto the regular schedule for YGPT then. But, yeah, it's gonna be pretty interesting, I hope. We're in Naughty's lair. Look at this. I always like the boss music for this game. Plus, DK has, like, the best victory music for any battle ever. How do you not feel, like, completely accomplished in everything you've done when you hear that music? Like, I wish for my graduation, like, I could have, like, been, like, the one sitting close to the, like, the microphone in the crowd. Or not in the crowd, like, in the place where, like, people, like, you know, like, the graduating class class students, like, sit. I wish I could be the one, like, sitting closest to the mics, and then just, like, have the victory music, like, on some kind of music player at full blast. So then when it's, like, you're graduated, throw your hats up, I could just be, like, pull a total Diddy Kong, just be like, I'm such a dork. Oh, my lord. Anyway. Sorry, I've got you guys hanging on a black screen now. I pre-recorded all this. This is all post-commentary. I didn't mention that, but anyway. I hope you all enjoyed the first episode. A lot of it is just going to be kind of like laid back, me talking about stuff, because it's all pre-recorded, right? Like, I'm not talking in the moment. So, I'll come up with some cool things to talk about. I'll keep you guys updated on anything that needs to be kept updated on. I guess, like, Evo happened, over the weekend, too. I don't care about Evo. I really don't care about fighting games all that much. But anyway, that's a thing that happened. Germany won World Cup. Cool. Awesome. Awesome. Yeah, go Germany. Sorry. Was that racist? There's no implication to why I was doing that, so probably. Anyway, just doing an accent for no reason. I'm gonna go now. Peace.